Hello and welcome back. In the last session, we have seen lambda functions. We'll take a look at the scope of the variable. Scope is nothing but visibility of that particular variable. Okay, we will look at scope now. So let me define a variable called x here, and I will assign value 15 to it. Okay, now let me define a method here called multiply. Here I am going to return x multiplied by 2, and before this I am going to print the value of x here. Okay, let me call this function multiply. So what will be the output of this print x? Okay, since x is defined at the global level, so the value of x will be 15. So that means before defining this particular method or function, we have defined this particular variable. So that means this variable is accessible to all the functions within that particular file, and the value of x will be 15. So it will return 30 here. So let me print the value here. Print multiply, and let me print x value. Okay, let me execute this. So this is printing 15 here, and this print is 30, and this is 15. Okay, so these two statements are within the function multiply. Okay, so these statements are outside the function. So inside the function, the value of x is 15. So that is why this is a global variable. That is why this particular variable has got global scope. That means even if I define another function, so return, for example, x divided by 3. And if I call and divide here and then print the value which is returned by divide, then I should get 5.0 here. So the x value for all these functions will remain 15 since it is defined globally. Suppose say if I define another variable here, y is equal to 6. Now instead of returning x multiplied by 2, so let me multiply it with y. So let me comment out this. For the time being, so let me comment out this statement as well. After calling the multiply, I want to print x and y here. Okay, let me execute this. Now I get an error saying that y is not defined. That is after I called multiply. Multiply is giving me 90. So this is the value which is written by this multiply method or function. Okay, now after that it says name y is not defined. So this variable is not accessible outside this function. So that is why the scope of this particular variable is a local scope. This variable is visible only within this particular function. We cannot access this variable outside the function. Okay, now what will happen if I declare x again here? Let me say x is equal to 15, sorry, x is equal to 10. So the global variable value of x is 15. However, I have defined the same variable x with value as 10 within the multiply function. Let us see the result by executing this. I have taken out y here because we were getting the error. So let me execute this. For multiply, the result is 60. And here I'm printing x. So let me print y also within the multiply function. Let me re-execute this. Now this is printing 10 and 6. So x is 10 and y is 6. And this multiply function is returning me 60. Instead of using 15, it is using 10 now. So this x variable is again of local scope. Even though the variable name is same, it is using the value from here, which is declared within the multiply function. Now earlier we had seen that we were getting error here. So you can see a red squiggle here. It says unresolved reference y. Okay. Now I want to change the scope of this variable y to a global scope rather than local scope. How do I do it? So there is a way to do this by using global keyword. And I define y as global first, and then I assign a value. Okay. Let me execute this. Now you can see y is accessible even outside the function by declaring that variable as global. Now this y is not local scope. Now this has become global scope because of this global keyword. In Python, you can also have nested functions. For example, def func1 okay, let me declare a variable here called x is equal to 12 in this case, and I will define another function here, func2. So let me print the value of x here, and I will call this func2. And outside this, I will call this function func1. Okay, so this is the first function which I have defined, and within this function, I have a variable which is declared as x is equal to 12. And I have another function. Within this function, I'm trying to access this variable which is defined outside this function. Let us execute this and see. Okay, let me comment out the earlier code so that you don't get confused. Okay. Okay, now it is 12. It is printing 12 here. So I have this function 2 here because we will be able to call only the outer function. So this is the outer function and this is the inner function. So within this function, since x is defined outside this function, so this function 2 will also have access to this x here. However, if I define y is equal to 10, for example, and then I want to print x and y within function 2, and I want to print the value of y within function 1. Print y. Now, as soon as I type in print y, you can see it is unresolved reference y. So that means y is not accessible. Since y is defined within function 2, so y is not available in function 1. So let me take this out and print this. okay, 12 and 10. So now if I try to access x and y, so both will not be available here because both of them are defined within the function. None of these are global. So the scope here is global for function 2 and local for function 1. However, y is local for function 2. So x is global for func 2 and local for func 1. I hope this is clear. This is somewhat confusing topic. So if you have any queries, you can always get back to me. And that is the end of this session. Thanks for watching.